Hey there, everybody. This is LJ Wapker from p4.org. We held our first p4 user workshop at Stanford in June of 2015. We had about a dozen different demonstrations from multiple vendors and academics who were all working on various p4 targets and tool sets. We got a few of them recorded and are posting them here on the p4.org webpage for people to watch and hopefully get a better idea of what sorts of things the community is working on. I apologize in advance for some of the background noise in the not exactly Hollywood production quality. We were recording these live and trying not to get in the way of people who were there attending the workshop in person. This demonstration is showing us how P4 can be combined with Rocker. Scott Feldman, the Rocker maintainer, couldn't be here in person due to a family event, so Parag was kind enough to do the demonstration. Dare I say, let's get rockin'? Yeah, sorry.
So what I'm showing here is integration of P4, or how we can get P4 integrated and start testing P4 programs inside Linux kernel. So what is happening in the Linux kernel is with SwitchDev and Rocker. SwitchDev is a driver that enables offloading of switching ASICs, or support for switching ASICs in the Linux driver, in the Linux kernel. And that allows Linux to offload forwarding information like FTPs, routing tables, into a fast path device that can then do a packet forwarding. So as SwitchDev is being designed and getting open sourced by Scott, we needed some device to go with that driver so that we can test the driver. And that device today is a Rocker. Rocker is an emulated device that emulates OFDPA pipeline. Now, why OFDPA? Because that's the only open source pipeline that you can implement and without worrying about proprietary APIs and so forth. So then what we thought is, if we can do it with OFDPA, why not with P4? Because P4 is also open. So we took the approach where we actually added P4 pipeline to Rocker device and associated driver in the Rocker driver, which supports P4 pipeline. And that way now we can actually define a P4 pipeline or a P4 defined behavior for packet forwarding and integrate with Linux driver and actually test it with Linux. So that's what I'm showing here on the left hand side, where the demo setup that we have is really what we did was we took the Rocker device and took two ports of Rocker, kept them with the OFDPA pipeline the way it is, and then took the other two ports of Rocker associated with the P4 pipeline. And we can extend that to, you know, add the other ports to other P4 pipelines as we experiment with P4 or change the program or do something like that. So what that gives us is now you can offload the Linux bridge or Linux routing onto a P4 device using existing Linux tools, because it uses like IP route 2 or other utilities that you use or that you're used to when you configure L2 or L3 inside Linux, and you can just use that. And then you can start testing your P4 programs without waiting for the devices or anything natively within the Linux.
Okay. So
So now if you go to the demo, so what I did was, instead of making a very complicated P4 program, we have a very, very simple P4 program that does very simple L2 forwarding right now, and it has some L3 capabilities also. So if you see, the program is very simple. You get a packet, you derive port VLAN, you do the VLAN membership check, the simple VLAN membership check. If the packet is intact, you give it a default tag. If it is in the wrong VLAN, you drop it. But once you accept the packet, then you do the source MAC learning by doing a source MAC lookup, and if the lookup misses, then send the packet to CPU for learning, and that goes to Linux bridge, and Linux bridge does all the learning things that it does today. And if it's IPv4 packet, then you can look at, you can do the RMAC lookup, see if it's a routable packet and route it if it's a hit. If it's not routable packet, then just do regular L2 forwarding using DMAC lookup. Now, good thing here is I can keep this program as simple as I want. Like for in this case, I don't do any flooding. So if there's a DMAC lookup miss, I can actually use Linux bridge to do its thing and do the flooding for me. So we have very, very flexible way of, you know, offloading what we want and offloading what we don't want to offload. And with this, with these things, I was able to really within a month or so integrate this with Rocker and actually start testing my P4 program right away on Linux. That's what I'm going to show it here. So here what I have is, this is a switching system that's right there, which is using QMU because of the emulation. And here it's a QMU monitor, so we know what's going on here. So if you see on the monitor right now, there are two FDPA ports and there are two locker ports. Locker ports are right now not up. I can bring them up here. So P3 and P4 are the two locker ports. So I bring up port 3 and I bring up port 4. And here if you see the bunch of actions that happen, like default VLAN programming and so forth. And then I can go here and show that all the four ports are up, locker ports are up. And then, actually I was already running the ping here, but I can stop that. And here if you see, I'm using Linux bridge command to just show the FDB that's populated in the hardware. And here you can see that the two MAC addresses that are corresponding to the two hosts in VLAN 55 are actually learned here. So you can see they are learned in VLAN 55 and they're on port 3 and port 4. And you can actually, just to make sure that's what they are, I can bring down a port and you will see one of the addresses disappeared. And then I start ping again, and I can, this time I can do just one frame so that we can see what all is happening on the pipeline. I need to bring up the link. Oh, sorry. Okay. And now I run the ping. So here you see the address is learnt again because you got a new packet. And if I look at some of the logs that are coming from the P4 simulator, then you will see that a bunch of packets initially got punted to CPU because we had not learned the entries. And as we learn the entries, then entries got programmed, like, you know, SMAC got added, DMAC got added. And after that, you would see that SMAC and DMAC were just the hit for the packet. And you will see also that there's a MAC learn notification that's going up as we learn the packet. So that's what basically, you know, to get to this ping state, if you see on a fixed function ASICs or, you know, in previous experience, people take a long time just to get ping working. And here I was able to do it with P4 in a really short time with Rocker. So I think this will provide an excellent tool to start developing P4 and start experimenting with it, start testing it in a real environment. So I think that's our plan. And that's the power of this Rocker and Switch Dev. And then obviously, whatever we are doing, we will put everything in open source. And also, next steps really are, you know, right now you can see this program is really, really simple. It doesn't do a lot of things that people want. But we would be enhancing this program, add more features. And as Switch Dev is developing, we'll add more and more offload capabilities to P4-defined pipeline. So that's the plan. Cool.